Hi, my name is Stephanie, and today I want to talk to you about a saliva test meant to indicate autism.
Stephanie from the future interrupting here just to let you know that if you wait until the end of the video, I am going to be announcing a giveaway and the rules for entering it. So be sure to stay till the end of the video.
So autism is typically diagnosed through the observation of basically behavior, whether people have met milestones, how they've been developing, and then also if they do like repetitive behaviors and all those things. Now, the frustrating thing for a lot of people is if you're not the stereotypical autism, if you're not what some people would call low functioning or level 3 support needs or whatever else, if it's not glaringly obvious, a lot of professionals will miss it. Or even down to the simple fact that you are female, some professionals still don't think that autism happens in females. So it is kind of frustrating, and it's also kind of difficult because a lot of times what happens for people, especially with like children, they'll get screened and then they'll get sent for another screening and then they'll get sent for some tests and then they'll be put on a wait list. And it's not always easy to tell what exactly people are dealing with. So this happened. This company has created something called Clarify ASD. It is a saliva test meant to indicate autism. So right now it is actually on the market. It's a really close to $1,000, and it is not covered by insurance anywhere that I'm aware of or the person who wrote the article is aware of. I doubt it will be anytime soon. You can only get Clarify ASD through a prescription, and then a medical professional has to order it and has to administer it. This test has been shown to be 85% accurate. Now, it is meant to be used in conjunction, so it's not kind of like a bypass. Clearly, 85% is a lot, but it's not exactly definite, so it's not like you can just spit in a tube and find out for sure if you're autistic or not. So it's supposed to be used in, say, that you fail the MCHAT-R, then you could maybe take this test, and if it comes up positive for autism, then the professional may be more assured in being able to say that someone has autism or is autistic. The idea apparently is to get people off of wait lists faster and to get them into behavioral therapies, as quoted by the individual presenting the company that made it. Now, what I've personally found maybe the most interesting about this is that not only is it like, do you have autism, do you not? It also distinguishes between non-autistic developmental delays. And this is something that's hard for people to tell a lot of times, a lot of why some people will wait forever for a diagnosis, even though it might seem really clear to some, because it's hard to, just based off of behavior and observation, to tell if you're dealing with a developmental delay, autism, both, another disability, and so on. So what's cool about Clarify ASD is that 85% accuracy is also coming from, you know, differentiating between autism, non-autistic, and then non-autistic developmental delay. So that was pretty interesting to me. Basically, the way it works is there's ribosomes, I want to say it's ribosomes, that is found in most autistic people, I guess, and they basically test that. These people are making other types of tests for other sorts of things. I imagine this was probably made possible by all the people who like donated their information. I don't really know, but there are companies who are basically using everyone's like free databases to come up with stuff. Now, while this is great that it can help differentiate, and 85%, again, it's pretty good. It's not, you know, 100%, but it's pretty good. And it could help people get a diagnosis faster than being on a waiting list forever. They did, you know, say they were looking to getting people into those interventions and treatments. And while I'm not a big fan of those particular words, because again, it does sound like you're treating some sort of disease or something, and as if you can just like make ASD go away, I get what they're saying. If you want to get support to people faster, if you want to get understanding and answers to people faster, that's fantastic. But what that's also going to do, I would hope, would put a bigger demand on the treatments to prove that they are effective, these therapies, to prove that they are effective and ethical and good long-term. And that is something that, say, ABA, I don't think can stand up to. I think that these therapies need to be vetted. These therapies need to be looked into again, any therapy that claims to be working with autism, because we're gonna probably start seeing influxes. There's also a blood test that they made. It's not the same company. About a year ago got released. Again, these aren't gonna be like, just take this and we know for sure, but it's supposed to help with the diagnostic process. But that just puts more need for us to help people understand what helps and what doesn't, because it's possible that if this becomes more accessible, that, you know, professionals might be taking those waiting lists, making them smaller, and increasing the demand immediately for therapies, if that makes sense. Again, I could be completely wrong. It might just be all the same. But either way, I feel a little more urgency to kind of make information aware and hope that communities also will take into consideration, like, you have an autistic population. One of the biggest things I hear is that programs don't know how to deal with autistic children, so they always just send them to ABA because ABA is always like, yeah, you know, send us your autistic kid, we can deal with them all the time. Where other groups won't be both like child care and also equipped to handle autistic children and their different ways of being. It's kind of, it's weird, honestly, to me how awkwardly different people make autistic children, but whatever. But I would hope to see that there are more places in these communities for more information about therapies and supports and understanding what really helps these autistic individuals, especially if we do start seeing more effective methods of being like, yeah, we don't have to wait for several years. We do the MCHAT, we do the follow-up, and then we do this, you know, clarify ASD or whatever else. And they can say, yeah, pretty sure, let's go on and move forward instead of, you know, sitting on wait lists. So anyway, those are some thoughts I had. I thought it was interesting to see that run across my feed at some point, that there was actually a saliva test for it. Unfortunately, it's not like you're gonna 100% know if you got it. It's not, you can't self-administer it either. You have to have a prescription. So it's not like, you know, I can just order it right now and test myself and be like, yay, I can be sure 85% accuracy. But I do think it can be helpful in those cases. And that, again, is if either the price goes down or insurance starts covering that. I don't see that being something that would happen immediately. What do you guys think? I'm interested in your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below.
All right, guys. So I wanted to share this giveaway with you guys. I am going to be giving away 3 sets of Stim toys or fidgets or whatever you want to call them. The rules are simple. I just need you to be subscribed to me on YouTube and leave me a comment. Of course, you can always say whatever you think of the video, and then just make sure that you say that you do want to be entered into the giveaway. If I pick a comment that does not say that they want to be entered, I will move on to the next person. Now, this does actually apply for Facebook as well. I will be picking 1 winner from Facebook and 2 winners from YouTube. If you didn't know, I do have a Facebook page. It will be linked in the description box. And on Facebook, I just need you to be liked and following my page. And again, comment your thoughts on the video and make sure that you include that you would like to be entered for the giveaway. Entry for the giveaway ends on Wednesday, February 19th at 11:59 p.m. Central Standard Time. So please get your comment in before then. And I should be announcing the winners on Thursday, February 20th.
If you enjoyed this video, found it interesting, whatever else, go ahead and hit the like button if you like autism-related content. I do try to post to this channel every Thursday at 4 p.m. Central Standard Time with autism-related content. So feel free to subscribe if you would like to. I hope that you're having a wonderful week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!